here are medicines for ADHD. Just to remind you, these are the different medicines. We have we don't really have first, second, and third line, although I'm going to walk you through these. We have the stimulant medications, which include methylphenidate and amphetamine. You have the noradrenergic agents, atomoxetine and viloxazine XR. Then you have the alpha agonist, clonidine, guanfacine extended release are the FDA-approved ones. And then, to remind you, the combination of alpha agonists and stimulants are approved. And then you have those that are not FDA-approved but have empiric-based data. These are your medicines that you're going to be using in kids who have bipolar and ADHD. This is your algorithm available. The one comment I'm going to make is that most of the data I'm presenting are with stimulants. We have very little data with non-stimulants in kids who have bipolar and ADHD. So we have, in some ways, our comfort zone is with a class of medicines that you're like, ugh, I'm a little bit nervous about using this medicine in somebody who has bipolar disorder. So kind of put your seatbelt on, because that's what we're going to be looking at moving forward. The other issue on the stimulants are lots of different stimulant preparations. I strongly recommend you pick an immediate release, intermediate release, and extended release from the methylphenidate and amphetamine family. They are not the same when it comes to the reaction for mood. Sometimes you get better outcomes with the shorter acting as opposed to the extended release. It's a little bit counterintuitive. This is a clinical pearl. This is something hard-earned in terms of taking care of a lot of these kids. So think about that with methylphenidate and amphetamine. Immediate acting, intermediate acting, and extended release preparations. Just shifting those may actually help you in terms of managing kids. You may have find that using an extended release methylphenidate is helping ADD, but it keeps dysregulating the kid even though everything else is okay. And all you need to do is shift it to immediate release methylphenidate 2 or 3 times a day and things got better. And then you're like, how can that be? And Joe Biederman used to always say, it's like putting your finger through a flame. If you do it quickly, like an immediate release, it doesn't burn your finger. But if you do it really slowly, I don't recommend that, by the way, it'll hurt. So think about that when you're thinking about these medicines. Sometimes the shorter acting are your friends in the face of mood disorders. Tuck that away.